Hare Hare Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Nityai Gauranga Nityai Gauranga
Nityai Gauranga Nityai Gauranga
Nityai Gauranga
He had to go return a rental car, Gurudev.
Huh?
He had to go return a rental car.
And where is Ramesh Prabhu?
He went also to bring back a rental car.
Radhe Jai Jai Madhava Dante. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestha Bhutale Kishmadhakti Tajnana Kishavaiti Ati Matra Charitraya Svashitanan Chapahine Jiva Dukhe Sadakai Nama Prema Pudaya Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyasya Kripa Sindhu Bhyayivasya Patitanam Pavanindhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayati Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gauratishuni Gurave Gaurachandraya Radhikayai Tadalayai Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tada Bhaktaya Namo Yang Praprajanta Manupeta Mapeta Kritya Dvaipayano Virahakatare Ajihava Utreti Tanmayataya Sarvo Bhinedo Tantara Bhaktari Dayan Muninan Tavai Vasmi, Najuyami Tayabina, Kipichnaya Raja, Tamnaya Mama Charnaya. My humble obeisances in the lotus feet of my transcendental Gurudev, Om Vishnu Vasishma Sankhita Jnana Kesava Goswami Maharaj. And same thousands of my humble obeisances in the Lord's feet of my Shiksha Guru, Om Vishnu Vasishma Bhakti, Vedanta Swami Maharaj. Especially I have come by the inspiration given by my Shiksha Guru, Srisila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, and to obey him, I am coming here and there. My main purpose is to glorify him, also my Gurudev, and also our Guru Parampara. Now I am seeing, oh, prominent problem what is. If a man, as by reading books or by hearing his Gurudev or devotee, he understands that world is nothing but like a dream, and in this world everything is momentary. It cannot help us, this world. So knowingly this, by reading any shastra or hearing from Gurudev or for any devotee, not by realization but only by hearing, and he gives up worldly life. And he wants to practice bhakti yoga. But by hearing, he only understands these things, but he has no taste in hearing Hari Katha, in Hari Naam, especially in the serving of his Gurudev and devotees, and in testing hearing Hari Katha in the council of a high class of devotees. This situation is very critical, very, very critical. To survive in this critical situation, very hard. And we are almost all in this. No taste in all these things, but we have left also world. Very critical. In this situation, if you have not taken a decision, very firm or strong decision, that I should not give up that association, high class, not serving Gurudev, we should serve our Gurudev. This firm and strong, this mood is there, then he can be saved, otherwise not. And that is why so many devotees came to my Sitya Guru, your Prabhupada. So many devotees, lakhs and lakhs from different parts of whole world. And they were in this critical position. They left world, but no taste in Hari Katha so much. Only they helped in some way outwardly to their Gurudev. I told about these things in my class of California,
San Francisco.
Yes, in evening class. Do you remember something, the points, or you can speak them? They should all hear and realize that where we are. More.
Om Jnanam Timiranjasya Jnanam Dina Salaka Chaksuram Militam Yena Tasmai.
You should point out the points.
In San Francisco, Srila Gurudev explained that at the present time, this is the most important thing to think over. Why did this happen, that so many disciples of our Srila Prabhupada received Harinam and Diksha initiation, were serving our Gurudev so much, opening temples, becoming number one and number two in book distribution in the world, opening up gurukulas, and some even taking renounced order sannyas, most living in the brahmacharya ashram with our Gurudev. But after his departure, thousands became very weak, and they gave up the renounced order, entered into materialistic type family life, and gave up their practices of Krishna consciousness. This question, he said, is the most important question of the present time. When the guru gives the seed of bhakti, and the disciple plants that seed in his heart, it's very important that he water that seed regularly by hearing Harikatha and trace the sadhu
sangha. You can come here, give his shirt to him. New boy, this would be. Especially those are hanging. Oh, they are what? Using.
Lucky.
Okay. Huh? Okay. Lucky. Oh, yes, sir. That's what. You should sit there. You are very young.
Ramesh Prabhu is different.
Ramesh Prabhu should come here. Here. You can swing no hard. Perhaps you have come for swinging. Well.
He gave a very clear answer that, as he's saying now, we gave up our material activities, but on the other side had no taste for Harikatha. He gave the example of Kala Krishnadas, who accompanied Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as his personal servant in South India. He was doing so much service for Mahaprabhu and helping him in so many ways. So he was very lucky. However, he had no taste for inquiring from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, please answer my doubts, please tell me Harikatha. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was going all over South India and making so many people Vaishnavas, but what happened to this servant who had no taste? He became attracted by the Bhattacharis, Bhattataris, the gypsy girls, and he became enchanted and even left the association of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then on the other side, Srila Gurudev said, here's another type of disciple, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. Right from his young age, he had so much taste in hearing from his Gurudev, Yadunandanacharya, from Srila Haridas Thakur, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Swarup Damodar, Gadadhar Pandit, and ultimately Sanatana Goswami, and more ultimately Rupa Goswami. He always wanted to hear from them, and he learned from them how to chant in the right process. And he became so successful. He's the number one Rupanuga Bhakta of all existence. So here's two kinds of disciples. Gurudev was explaining that when we plant the seed of bhakti in our heart, we have to regularly water it by chanting and hearing in pure devotee association. Then, when that seed grows a little bit and it becomes a sprout and some roots start taking hold in the earth, at that time not so much water is required as before, but now that gardener, that disciple, that aspiring devotee has to make a fence around his baby creeper. And what is that fence? That fence, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told Srila Rupa Goswami, is the association of pure devotees. Particularly, he has to take shelter of that devotee who has become like a giant tree. His roots are deep, deep in the soil, and he doesn't require watering from anywhere outside. He's self-supportive, and no elephant, even a mad elephant, cannot go near that tree and do any harm. The mad elephant represents offenses to Nam, to Vaishnavas, to Seva, to Thakurji, to all Jivas, particularly to Vaishnavas. And the fence represents the association of pure devotees. And so one has to chant in that association in the right process. So many examples Srila Gurudev gave of the right process. That is, one should avoid the association of non-devotees. He explained who is a non-devotee, the Mayavadis, those who are associating with women, or those who are very friendly with those who are associating with women, one should avoid that person's association. One should follow Cheto Darbana Marjanam Bhava Mahada Vagni Nirvapunam, the process that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu set up, particularly the four, becoming, feeling lower than the straw on the street, more tolerant than a tree, devoid of all sense of false prestige, and ready to offer all respects to others without any desiring any in return. And Nam Namakari Bahudar, lamenting, grieving, singing the prayers of our previous acharyas that I have no attachment for your holy name, although you've invested all of your powers in that holy name. So sadhu sangha sarva shastra koi, sarva siddhi sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha sarva siddhi hoi. All the shastras say that sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha, even a little bit, can give full perfection. And even a little bit of what? Five. There's numbers. These four, becoming lower than the straw on the street, more tolerant than the tree, offering respect to others and not desiring any. And these five, what is that? Chanting the holy name in the association of pure devotees, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam in their association, living in Vrindavan, if not by body, then by mind, in that association, and serving Thakurji with faith in that association. Everything comes back to that association, and when one does so, then he tastes that Anandamuri Bardhanam. He swims in the waves of love and affection of Krishna, and Gurudev gave on that evening the example of Mahaprabhu, who was swimming in the waves of the ocean, having jumped in by thinking that it was the Jamuna, feeling so much separation from Krishna, having chanted in that right process, "Oh, son of Nanda, I'm your eternal servant. But although I am so, somehow or other I've fallen to this material ocean of birth and death. Please pick me up and engage me as an atom of your lotus feet." That kind of helplessness and humility in the association of pure devotees. Then he told the story of how the fishermen caught Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his net, how Sarup Damodar was the ghost exorcist to relieve that fisherman of his so-called ghost, how they performed Sankirtan to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and how he lamented that, "Oh, I was serving Radha and Krishna and the gopis, they were engaging me and Krishna was loving me. And then you woke me up for that." He told the story of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to his teacher, his spiritual master, Srila Ishwarapuri, and said, "What is this mantra that you've given me? You've told me how to chant it, that there's nothing. Kalona steva na steva na steva gatira nita, there's nothing but this holy name. You told me that I should consider myself a fool and take this name as my very life, that nothing else will make me happy. So I did that, but what happened? What did you give me, Gurudev? I've become like a madman. How? My Harinam turned into a sham-colored boy. The very Harinam turned into Krishna, and I saw him playing a flute and gazing at me with sidelong glances. And I went to follow him. I went to catch him, but he began moving backwards here and there. When I was just about to capture him, he disappeared, and I became like a madman and began rolling on the ground. Oh, my beloved Krishna, where are you? Where are you?" So Gurudev is giving the process from the beginning, Cheto Darpana Marjanam, Pratipadam Punamitam Svadanam, how one can taste nectar, Radha Krishna's leelas at every step by following this right process and going beyond that critical stage.
Thank you.
So, we should think about this very critical position. Those who think that now I have become Guru, we have served for 20 years or Prabhupada, nothing to know more, nothing to hear, nothing to read, Bhakti Vinod Thakur Srila Prabhupada. We have only come from our Prabhupada. We know only Prabhupada. It means he nothing, he knows nothing. False ego only. You can compare this situation with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Even being Supreme Personality of Godhead himself, Brijendanandan, and how he questions Raya Ramananda and hears. Very patient. Questioning and he is answering. Though all the things are coming from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is inspiring him. But who is he speaking? Who is solving the questions? Oh, Raya Ramananda. Anyone comes to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he tells that, I don't know Harikatha. I have heard something from Raya Ramananda. If you want to hear Harikatha, you should go to
Raya Ramananda.
You know one Brahmachari, Nishinghananda or Sadyumna Mishra, Nishinghananda also. He sent, but he returned back. Was not satisfied. He saw that he was engaged in, Raya Ramananda was engaged in serving very teenager girls and making them bath, decorating them everywhere. Oh, they were naked, but even decorating them and telling the poses how to dance in front of Jagannath. And the modes. So he thought that he is not a good devotee. He is with naked girls, teenagers, and he is decorating them in a lonely place. No one is there. I cannot believe in on his character. So he must be any loose character. And then he returned back. Mahaprabhu told her, have you heard? Oh, he was engaged in something and so I returned back. Oh, you must go again and tell that, Gauchandra has sent me to hear some Harikatha to you. And then he again went. Raramanam told, he did pranam to that Brahmin. It may be that he has taken the lotus dust of that Brahmin Nishinghananda. But now he was so much regard for that Raya Ramananda. He told that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has sent me to hear something. Oh, Mahaprabhu has sent. Oh, I must help you. Then what Harikatha you want to hear? Oh, the same thing that you have told to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Same thing I want. And then, knew that this person, this Brahmin and devotee, had no idea of anything, A, B, C, D. So he began to question himself and answering also. Wow. A pure devotee can ask any question. Otherwise, those who don't know A, B, C, D of Bhakti Marg, they cannot ask any pure question. And without questioning, they cannot hear, they cannot know anything. So, tad vidhi prani pathena pari prasnena shivaya. Three things should be there. Then they will give something, instruction. Otherwise not. Without seva, without unconditional surrendering, and without very humble questions. Any tattvavid cannot sprinkle their mercy to you. First be like this. I know everything. I am Guru. So I'm making questions only to know that you know or not. Oh, this is not so. Then he went and he told that, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has sent. And then he was questioning and answering both. And when he heard all these things, now First he gave his lotus dust to him, and now he fell flat, rolling on the earth. O Prabhu, now you are my son. Please be merciful. And having so much glorification in his heart, he returned to Mahaprabhu, and he also, oh, really you have done, sprinkle your mercy that you have sent here. Otherwise, I have not known all these things. So himself, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is hearing. And you think that, oh, we have now become perfect. And Guru, no need of reading Rupa Goswami, Srila Prabhupada, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta, Sati Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Oh, we have done and served so much. Now you are really Guru. Then you are not Guru, you are what?
Kangaroo.
Kangaroo of where? Australian kangaroo. You should be tight. I hear that, oh, among my senior disciples, they don't attend any classes because they know all everything. But I know that they don't know anything, ABCD. False. They must attend all. Without attending high association, you cannot know anything. So give up this false ego and attend classes without any hesitation. And here, not only he, you know, Raghunath Das Goswami, whole his life was engaged in hearing. She told from Jadunandan Acharya, from Haridas Thakur, from Sachinandan Gaurhari, again Nityananda Prabhu, again to Sarup Damodara, Haraya Ramananda, Sarup Damodara, and then Gadadhara, and all Vaishnavas there in the Council of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu at Gambhira. And after that, he took shelter in the lotus feet of Rupa and Sanatha. So, we should try to be like that. That is why we see that by hearing in high class of association, we should try to fix our goal of life. If no goal of life, then everything is useless. And that is why in Chaitanya Charitamrita, first Srila Krishna Das Goswami, hearing from Rupa Raghunath and all of us, wanted to fix our goal, especially in first Adi Lila, third and fourth. Chaitanya. He has definitely, strongly, he has established that what goal is supermost. Especially in Raya Ramananda Sambhad, he has described so many objects and so many processes. And he has given so many definitions of these. But we don't read to accept all these things. Very deeply we don't want to go inside. And that is why we are always weak and weak. If anyone will hear all these things from a bona fide devotee, then he will very easily fix his goal of life. Goal of his Satan Bhajan. Otherwise, no. So, in first chapter, third and fourth, what were the causes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to come? What were the causes that Krishna wanted to come to this world with his all associates? Taking the mode, intrinsic mode of Radhika and golden
complexion.
why he came. And in this thing, oh, he is explaining all these things. What he has heard from where? Guru, Raghunath especially, he heard. He heard from them, oh, the idea, mood of Sarup Damodar, that is Lalita, Vishakha, Rayanamananda. And then he has told something in third and fourth chapter. What was that cause? Can you? In brief.
Four
reasons. In brief. You can take it. Very. If you want to keep all these things in your heart, then attentively hear all these things. Because you have left everything and come here for 7 days here from different parts. So you should take something.
Jnanandana-shalakaya chakshur-unmilitam jena tasmai sri-gurave namaha. Srila Gurudev has ordered me to repeat something what I have heard from Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, especially here in the Adilila chapter 3 and 4. Srila Krishna's Kairaj Goswami is explaining very deeply the reason for the appearance of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Our acharyas have explained very clearly that Mahaprabhu, he has two reasons for appearing in this world. His primary reasons and his secondary reasons. So first of all, the primary reason. This also has two parts, primary, and so secondary, primary reason. So first of all, Srila Swarup Damodar Goswami, he has explained, Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima Kidrisho Vainaiva.
Begin from beginning,
from bottom.
Yada yada hi dharmasya.
I'm explaining, not from starting from the top, starting from the bottom reason.
Don't go. Jump. Begin from.
We know from Bhagavad Gita, Krishna himself explained his reasons for coming in this world. Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyutana madhamasya tadatmanam sridhamyaham pritranaya sadhunam vinashya chajuskitam dharma samstapanatya sambhavami yuge yuge. Whenever the religion is on the decline and irreligion is rising up, at that time Krishna said, I appear myself. I destroy the demons and the influence in this world, and I protect the devotees, and I establish real religious principles. So when the age of Kali came, then Krishna himself, he appeared as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And one of his reasons for coming was this, to establish Yuga Dharma. What is the Yuga Dharma? Harinam Sankirtan. All should chant Krishna name. In this age of Kali, there is no other religious process but the chanting of the holy names. So this reason, this is very good. Also, before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared, Sri Advaita Charya, Krishna's own expansion had come into this world. And he was thinking, all are engaged in so many activities against devotional service. I want Krishna himself to come, and he will establish religious principles in this world. So Advaita Charya, he was worshipping his Shalagram Shila with Tulsi leaves and Ganga Jal, and with tears and crying very loudly. And by his calls, he inspired Krishna. Krishna was surely going to come in this age of Kali. But at which time he would come, at which moment, it was not fixed. But the call of Advaita Charya inspired him, I will come now and appear in Navadvipa. So to establish Yuga Dharma, and also by the call of Advaita Acharya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come into this world. But he has some very special reasons. So he is, Krishna himself is saying, Prema rasa nirjas karite ashadan, raga marga bhakti loke karite pracharan. I have come, I want to come to this world. Why? Raga marga bhakti loke karite pracharan. I want to give a type of bhakti which was not given before. What is that? Raga nuga bhakti. Many incarnations appeared in this world. Matsya, Varaha, Karma, Nishinga, Kalki, Parashuram, Ramachandra, Varahadev, Vamandev. So many have appeared in this world. And also so many acharyas came. Madhva Acharya, Ramanuja Acharya, Nimbaditya, Vishnu Swami. But though they taught something about bhakti, they taught Vaidhi Bhakti, devotional service which is performed according to regulative principles, inspired by the discipline of Shastra. But Krishna, he is not so much pleased by this bhakti. He can be pleased, but this type of bhakti cannot control him. So Krishna, he wanted to spread and establish and preach within this world Raga Nuga Bhakti. That means devotional service, following the moods of the residents of Vrindavan, who have natural family relationship with Krishna, which is free from all awe and reverence. So
he never came to establish Vaidhi Bhakti. Never. Because so many previous acharyas have done this. Especially for what he came.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to give this Ragamar. Why? He's saying, Sakale Jagati Kori More Vidhi Bhakti, Vidhi Bhakti Braja Bhava Paiti Nahi Shakti. All in this world are following Vaidhi Bhakti, but this doesn't have the power to awaken within the heart the love of the residents of Vrindavan. Aishwarya Gyaneti Sab Jagatami Shrit Aishwara Shitila Prema Nahi Mora Prit. He's saying that those who think that I am God and I am the Supreme Lord and they serve me with a mood of awe and reverence, that love, it cannot fully satisfy me or control me. I like the love of the bridge basses. My friends, they never think that I am God. They think I am equal to them. And what to speak of that? My mother thinks, oh, she is more than me. She thinks if I don't feed my son my breast milk, oh, then he will become weak and skinny. And more than that, the gopis, they can chastise Krishna and call him a cheater and a liar and so many things. And he enjoys this so much. This is very sweet music to his ears. So Krishna was thinking, I want to, the jivas of this world, they will have a chance to serve me with this very high class of love. And among the different moods, Mahaprabhu himself is saying, Yuga Dharma Pravataimu Nama Sankirtan. I will establish Yuga Dharma Nam Sankirtan. But something more than this. Chari Bhava Bhakti De Anachamu Bhuvan. I want to give the moods of Vrindavan, Shastra Sakya Vatsali and Madhurja. No one else can do this. Yuga Dharma Pravatana Hoya Angsa Hoite Ami Bina Nohiyane Braja Prema Dite. My angsas, my incarnations, they can establish Yuga Dharma. Advaita Acharya can come and establish Yuga Dharma. But no one can give Braja Prema. This is my prerogative. Only I am giving this. So Mahaprabhu came to give this. And among this Braja Prema, especially through Rupa Goswami Pad, Mahaprabhu wanted to give something that was never ever given before. So Rupa Goswami himself revealed in his Vidagdha Madhav Natak, Anarpita Charim Chirat Krunayavatirnaha Kalo Samarpayatum Unnat Ujwalara Sam Swabhakti Sriyam Hari Purata Sundara Juti Kadamba Sandipita Sadaridaya Kandare Spratuva Sachinandana. Srila Rupa Goswami is praying, may that son of Satyamata, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, appear in the innermost chambers of your heart. He is Hari, the Supreme Lord himself, but he appeared in his age of Kali with the sentiments and complexion of Srimati Radharani to give what was never given before in this day of Lord Brahma, in this Kalpa, for 8,460,000,000 years, 640 million years. It was never given before during this time. And what is that? Samarpayitum unnat ujwala rasam swabhakti sriyam. Unnat ujwala rasa. This is the mood of the gopis of Vrindavan. Parakya rasa bhakti. How they love Krishna without any mood of own reverence. Thinking not that Krishna is my husband. Thinking he is my paramo lover. And among them, Srimati Radharani is the highest. Unnat ujwala rasam swabhakti. Krishna here, swabhakti, the bhakti of Krishna's own nearest and dearest Srimati Radharani. So, Mahaprabhu has not come to give this. He came to give unnat ujwala rasam swabhakti sriyam, the beauty of the mood of Srimati Radhika. Here, Srila Ramananda Rai, he explains to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Mahabhav Chintamani Radhara Sarupa Krishna Prema Kalpalata Sakigana Hoy Tarapala Pushpapata. Radharani is like a creeper that fulfills all the desires of Krishna. And that creeper is so beautiful, especially when it has many leaves and flowers and small flowers, manjaris. When the wind will blow, then the leaves and manjaris, they'll all dance. So Radharani is like a creeper. And her sakis, they're like the leaves. And manjaris, or small flowers, they are her maid servants. So these manjaris, they are the beauty of the creeper, of Srimati Radharani. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came himself, and he wanted to give a special type of love. That is, the mood of the maid servants of Srimati Radharani. Rupa Manjari, Rati Manjari, and others. Even in their dreams, they have no desire at all to meet independently with Krishna. They only want to serve Radharani completely and make arrangements for her to meet with Krishna. It may be that Lalita and Vishakha, they are superior to the Manjaris. They are like their gurus even, giving them instructions and orders. So they are senior according to Padmarjada. According to etiquette of their position, Lalita and Vishakha, they are superior. But Raghunath Dasa Swami especially is praying, Sakyaya te mama namostu namostu nityam dasyaya te mama rasostu rasostu satyam. I give my pranam to the position of Lalita and Vishakha. They are so high, but I don't want to be like them. I only want to be the dasya of Srimati Radharani. Even though by Padmarjada, that means by the etiquette of their position, they are superior. By Seva Vaishistya, that means the speciality of the service opportunities, the Manjaris are more fortunate. They have more chance to be very close to Radharani and serve in so many intimate ways. So Mahaprabhu, he wanted to give this thing. So this is another reason for Mahaprabhu's appearance. Very special and important reason. And all the acharyas coming in the line of Srila Rupa Goswami Pad, they're in this mood and they are distributing this mood in the service of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And of all the reasons for Mahaprabhu's appearance, the first and prominent and primary reason of all was described by Swarup Damodar. Sri Radhaya Panaya Mahima Kiddisho Vaneva Sajonye Nadbhuta Madurima Kiddisho Vamadiya Sokta Bhava Sokyam Chasyahat Madanu Bhava Kiddisham Veti Lobhat Tad Bhava Dhyasamijani Sachigarabha Sindho Hadindu. He's saying that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared from the womb of Satyamata like the moon appearing from the ocean. Why? Because he had a very intense greed to understand three things. Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mahima. What is the glory of Radharani's love? It is so powerful. Krishna himself has admitted, Radhikara Prema Guru Ami Shishanat Ami Sadanana Nritte Nachaya Udbhat. The love of Radharani is so powerful. It is my guru. And it causes me to dance in various novel ways all the time. So what is the glory of Radharani's love? And so Jore Yenad Bhutama Durima. Krishna was thinking, oh, Radharani is so qualified, she attracts my mind. Yet she seems to be more attracted to me than I am attracted to her. There's something about me that I don't understand that she realizes, that she is tasting. E prema dwari nitya radhika akali amarama duriam rita ashodeya sokali. Radharani, through her love, she tastes my sweetness completely. Only she can do it by her love. So if I can be absorbed in the mood of Radharani, only then will I be able to see myself through her eyes and realize what are the sweetnesses in me. My venu madhuri, the sweetness of my flute playing. My Rupa Madhuri, the sweetness of my form. My Prema Madhuri, of my love, and my Leela Madhuri, of my pastimes. So this was the second of the threefold reasons which are primary for his appearance. And the third one, Krishna was thinking, in this world, those who are rishis and sages like Bharat Muni, they have written something about the love between male and females, and they have said both enjoy equally in their affairs. But he doesn't know my Vrindavan. Radharani, she experiences thousand times more happiness than me. What happiness does she experience? I have agreed for this. So the prominent reason of all is divided into three. Krishna wanted to realize the greatness of Radharani's love, the sweetness in him that only she can taste through her love, and the happiness that she feels in their loving relationship. And therefore, he appeared in this world as Satchinandan Gaura Hari.
I did think Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave some idea that what should be our goal of life, goal of our sadhana bhajan. Swamiji, Śrīla Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, your Prabhupada, my Sikhya Guru, he came to fulfill the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu this way, not for anything else. As you have heard that Nam Sankirtan is Yuga Dharma, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu never come for this, only Nam Sankirtan. So, you should also know that the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he wanted to fulfill the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So if he is not fulfilling this desire to preach this thing in this world, to give this thing, very thing, then how, by Nagar Sankirtan, how can he can do? So he has not come for this. Hearing this in Mathura, once whole ISKCON became upset. And they told, oh, he is
minimizing
our Gurudev. Glory. I told, oh, foolish person. All foolish. I'm glorifying that he has not come to do the job of Mahavishnu to establish Yuga Dharma. What is Nam Sankirtan? Or to do Dharma Pratishtha. He never came only for that. He came for the same reason that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. For the same reason from whom Rupa Goswami has appeared in this world. Only for this. And what was that? Oh, we have told. But to preach Raga Marga first. A guru can give this, Rupa Goswami, very easily. He gave it. Raga Marga. You should know what is raga. How you can know? If there is no high class of association, you should know first what is bhakti, what is uttama bhakti. You should know what is adhama bhakti. Adhama bhakti means?
Mishra bhakti.
Mishra bhakti. Aro Siddha Bhakti, Sangha Siddha Bhakti, amalgamated bhakti with karma and kyan. We should know all these things. And what is called sadhan? What is called sadhan? We should know. For beginners, Guru make it tell, Rupa Goswami tell, very good student. But really, what we are doing, this is not Uttama Bhakti or Madhyama Bhakti or Shuddha Bhakti even. Amalgamated. It comes in the Sreni.
Category
of what? Sangha Siddha or especially Aarup Siddha. These are not pure Bhakti. What is the definition of sadhana? What? You.
It is subject.
You should know what is sadhana bhakti. Go.
Vijyan, manasya vyan jara salakaya. So sadhana bhakti has been divided into two parts.
No, I want to know the definition.
So Rupa Goswami Pad has given definition. Kriti sadhyat bhavet sadhya bhavasya sadhana abhiyan nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakata mriti sadhyata.
What is the meaning?
Kriti sadhya. So sadhana bhakti means to perform activities with kriti by body, mind and words. To develop siddhasya bhavasya, the eternal mood situated in the jiva. So activities to attain the stage of bhav bhakti by body, mind and words, that is called sadhana bhakti.
Yo, pundarik.
Kriti sadhya bhavet sadhya bhavasya sadhana vidha nitya siddhasya bhavasya prakatyam hridi sadhyatam. The eternal mood, Nitya Siddha Bhav, is eternally perfected and there is no need to make any endeavors to get that because it's eternally existing. But for the conditioned soul, how he has to awaken that eternal perfected mood in his heart? Through Kriti Sadhya, by engaging his body, mind and senses in devotional activities. And when such engagement is tadatmik, means when it becomes one, like when we put an iron rod in fire, and then what happens? After a while, the fire and the iron, they become identical, hot. And the iron rod imbibes the quality of fire, and it can also burn anything. So similarly, although these mundane senses, they cannot touch the spiritual substance, the transcendental mood. But when under the guidance of Hari Guru and Vaishnavas, the bona fide Vaishnavas, when we practice bhakti, then by their association, these limbs of bhakti which are transcendental, they attain tadatma, the oneness with our senses. And then gradually, by focusing these endeavors to attain the particular mood in which one wants to serve Krishna, then this is called sadhana bhakti.
You.
More nearer here. And you cannot get up.
Don't fear, come near.
Always here. From beginning, where you were?
Where were you?
Huh?
I was trying to get a ride.
Why? I will chastise you.
So, Gurudev ordered me to explain about sadhana. Srila Rupa Goswami Pad has explained in his Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Kriti Saddha Bhavet Saddha Bhavasa Sadhanavida Nitya Siddhasya Bhavasa Prakattam Hridi Saddhata. So, we have heard from Srila Dharanya Maharaj and Srila Gurudev, we have to fix our goal at first. So what is our goal and how we can get that goal? We have to know very clearly. In these circumstances, I want to clarify another point that all jivas are, all living entities are eternal servant of Supreme Personality Godhead Krishna. And all of them, in their constitutional form, some kind of servitor mood inside